So we were talking about the solution for example 1, and that it's better really to use the position vector, cap r plus rho, and take the time derivative to get the velocity vector and the time derivative to get the acceleration vector. Otherwise, you end up with difficulties in trying to figure out what things like this item are. But in any case, we end up with the final solution as shown here, where the acceleration is grouped in terms of e sub r, e sub theta, and e sub phi. See if you can go down through and drive this equation out for yourself. It's important to practice this for yourself to make sure that you're able to handle it. Notice that we've substituted in every term for the expression for the acceleration. And so that this is the total acceleration of the plane with respect to cap O, cap X, cap Y, cap Z. And again, remember that Newton's second law, F equals ma, right, where this is the acceleration, this has to be with respect to a fixed coordinate system, cap O, cap Y, cap Z, for example. And we cannot use, just say, the acceleration with respect to the relative, the moving coordinate system or something like that. We actually have to use R double dot. That's with respect to a fixed point. And one thing you want to notice is that we can use this directly. As one more thing you want to notice is that we can use this directly in this equation. And one thing that's important to remember when we're using Newton's second law is that the coordinate system directions themselves can be changing. What's most important is that the tail of that vector be positioned at a fixed point. It doesn't matter if the coordinate system directions themselves are moving for this to be valid. Let's look at perhaps a better better problem. What we're going to look at is the windshield wiper on a car. It used to be that back about 10 years ago, there were Audi Quattro cars that were beating everyone else in the European races, and the reason was because they were four-wheel drive cars, and they were able to outdrive all the other cars that tended to be either front-wheel or rear-wheel drive. Most of them were rear-wheel drive cars. But for one particular season, they had a lot of problems, and it wasn't because of the car, but it was because of the windshield wipers. And actually, the windshield wipers broke down while they were racing, and they found that the drivers obviously couldn't see once the windshield wipers failed, and so they're unable to go around corners and all of that. And the reason for the problem, it turns out that if they noticed in the videos where the windshield wipers failed, it was actually around a tight corner, and for the first two races that they were competing in, and the replacement of the motors actually fixed the problem that drove the windshield wipers. But in any case, it shows what the ignorance of physics gets you into trouble with. But so let's take a look at that problem. Say we have a car, and this is sort of the hood of the roof of the car, and this is the front end of the car, and we have the windshield here, and windscreen, and then we have the windshield wiper, and we have Z pointing straight up from the car, and we have Z capex. Cap O, cap X, cap Y, cap Z over here, and this is at the, say, a center of a curve. So we have here, maybe if we draw it from the top, we have cap Z shown here, and we come out and we have this car that maybe is going around a corner or something, who knows, like that, and it's moving in that direction, and this is O here, and this direction coming out to the car, we'll call that R, all right, and this particular point in the car, in here, that particular point we'll call it O prime. So you see O prime here, and as you know, in most cars, especially race cars, the windshield is actually tilted back a lot, and we'll call that angle tilt. So if we draw the car from the side, or well, my version of a car anyway, all right. Pretty bad car for a car, but at any rate, this car as windshield is tilted back at an angle, as shown here. And that angle we'll call psi, like that. And so that's the angle the windshield is tilted back. And I'm sorry, alpha. It's alpha. Forgive me. And the angle of the windshield wiper on the windscreen with respect to the vertical. So if we look at the car from the front, windshield wiper is maybe tilted over like that, and this is along the windshield itself, okay, in this sort of vertical direction. And so this angle here, that is psi. Alright, so the windshield wiper is tilted over on the windscreen as shown here, and we're going to look at this particular point P. And alpha is the angle between the windshield and the z axis, the vertical axis, and then psi is the angle between the wiper and the vertical along the windshield. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to attach O prime R phi z attached to the windscreen, as shown here, so we have O prime R phi z. And then we're going to look at what happens to the windscreen. So what we've got is we've got an automobile windshield inclined at angle alpha with the vertical. On the windshield is a wiper of length L that oscillates such that psi is psi naught, where there's just some sort of constant, sine 3t. The auto is traveling at a constant speed around a circular path, which is going around a turn, so that point O prime is tracking out a circle of radius r. So if we go back to this, then what it's saying is that this radius here from O to the O prime out here at the car is just cap r. And what we're going to find is the total acceleration of the tip of the wiper, p, with respect to the ground. So let's look at the solution here. If we define a rotating and moving coordinate system, O prime R phi z, okay, and we say that's cylindrical coordinate system, which makes sense because this O prime point is going to trace out a cylindrical direction, and O prime R phi z actually is convenient for the cylindrical form. The coordinate system is rotating at a rate of omega b with respect to a. If this coordinate system here, if this coordinate system is b, and this coordinate system is a, the a system is fixed and b is not. So that coordinate system is rotating as v divided by r, right? Because the car is moving in this direction, the velocity v. And if you divide v by r, that's the angular rate, and that's going around that cap z axis at a rate of v over r, okay, and so that's our omega b with respect to a, right? And you notice that it doesn't matter if we use lowercase z or uppercase z, they're both in the same direction. It doesn't matter where we draw the vector at, because a vector doesn't change its definition, neither does its direction nor its length change when you change where it's located. So it doesn't matter where we draw this at, whether you use lowercase or uppercase z. And so we have omega b with respect to a is equal to v over r e, for the moment, lowercase z, say. So then we'll define a fixed coordinate system at the center of the circle that's traced out by O prime, and we'll call that cap O, cap X, cap Y, cap Z. All right, so remember, just we use a relative coordinate system definition. We go from cap O to cap O prime. That's the vector r, and that's just r e sub r, right, because that's the only component we have to worry about. Remember, we don't need an e sub phi or anything other thing like that, because the e sub r direction will change to make sure that this r cap r vector points directly at O prime at all times. And then from O prime, we'll go out here to P to try to figure out what the acceleration of this end point is on this windshield wiper. And so how do we find this row, this vector from O prime to point P? Well, you notice that we've already written it out here, and it's not especially easy to define, is it? Because it's a combination of a pair of angles. Well, one thing you can do when you're trying to figure out these kinds of problems is actually to think about the position, the angle of, say, this line that goes up the windshield, and write that in terms of E sub Z, say, and E sub phi. So if we call this direction, for the moment, remember how I talked about we just use unit vectors as we please? Well, we'll call this one I don't know, we'll call this an E sub L for lack of a better term for the moment. Alright, so E sub L, which goes up the windshield and is still vertical, right? If we look at it, we notice that the angle here between the windshield and the Z axis, that's alpha, and if we make that really small, then E sub L and E sub Z point in the same direction. So we can say the E sub L is basically E sub Z times cosine of alpha. Alright. And then we notice that if we make E sub L, the angle alpha here, nearly 90 degrees, that E sub L and E sub V are opposite each other. So we'll subtract off E sub phi sine alpha. So that's how we would write E sub L in terms of these two angles. Alright. Now then, we need to figure out how we might write the rest of it.